was able to send a report back to the Order via my old acquaintance, Andrew the Blacksmith. At least Miller will know that I am alive, that I haven't completed the mission, but haven't resigned from it either.
That's one serious pickle you're in. But I can help. I have friends, and they have friends who can relay everything you tell me to your guys from the Order. So, now you must return home, to Polis? Well, there's no direct route. Everything's cordoned off here. But I believe the Order has an outpost nearby. On the surface. The church in the marshes. Try that place. If we can get word to your people, they might meet you there. As for me, I started life anew. Left Kuznetsky Most. The Reds completely subverted the place, looking for traitors and spies, sending people to camps, or just shooting them. All because of the coming war. People are fleeing from Kuznetsky Most and the whole Red Line. Come here, Artyom. 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 Did you see the armored train the Reds are building? Well, we built something too, with the stuff the refugees are bringing. Here, take a look. This baby. The boys even gave her a name. You can't help but fall in love with her. She did a swell job running refugees. But hell, you can't save everyone. So, take it. We have people in Venice, too. When you get there, find Woodpecker and tell him where you left our baby. Climb aboard. Come on, climb aboard! Get in, Artyom. You won't break it. Start the engine. We're still tinkering with her, so the controls aren't perfect. But the lights are first class. No need to fear the spider bugs around her. And there's a lot of those in the far tunnels. You should go. It's a long way, so you shouldn't waste any time.
Thank you.
Pavel's group is advancing towards Tretikovskaya, also known as Venice. They have a few hours lead on me and are moving via frequently used tunnels. But I will catch up. I can't afford not to.
We shoot. We're armed.
We are armed. Swear by Lenin's name.
He doesn't look like a GB. I don't recognize the uniform.
Could he be one of ours? Look at all his weapons.
Don't shoot. We are civilians. There are women and children here. Leave and let leave, okay?
We're refugees from the Red Line. I'm in charge here, basically. Now there's nobody under my command. All the battle-worthy men went with the other caravan. Half a click ahead. I thought they'd protect us. But they were attacked. We heard the shooting. It subsided. But it doesn't look like our people survived. So we can't go any further. And if we go back, it's the firing spot for us. You look like you've seen your share of fights. Can you help us? It's not for me, but I pity the children.
So what do we do now? How do we live without them?
They might still be alive. Don't bury them yet.
But the shooting... The shooting was so loud. And now there's nothing.
And what if they won't?
Why? Why don't they come for us then?
They might come soon. Let's just wait.
Do you think they killed them all?
They could have. Or, it could be worse.
How?
Women were with them. Yasha, if ignorance is bliss, you're the happiest guy around.
So, are we going to help our guys or what?
What help can just the two of us be?
If they're feeling down, we could flank the bandits.
Let's get ready then.
Well, you're not going anywhere. Who's going to protect the women and children?
But we can't let the bandits butcher our guys.
That stranger is going to help us. Looks like he's worth 20 of you anyway.
You were an idiot to believe you're Andre the blacksmith.
Oh, it's safe. You'll get there in no time.
And you dragged me here. And now we're all gonna die because of your stupid blacksmith.
Shut your mouth.
Come again.
Andre's a saint. He got us all out and lots of people before us.
Yeah, he got us out just to be robbed by bandits.
And how the hell was he supposed to know about the bandits?
Then he shouldn't tell people it's safe. Such bullshit.
How about the GB? He did save us from them.
But what difference does it make if we're still going to be killed by bandits?
Dumb woman! I don't even
some buckshot in the gut sure makes any bandit
you
a dull boy.
Yasha.
Buy
what
some!
Made you flee?
Mobilization, of course.
Come again.
A boy your age.
These guys don't buy anything.
With their rifles.
They always overlook me. But then, I was summoned to duty. Mom said with my luck, I'd bite the dust the second I hit the front lines. So, she got into this catacomb. Which seems like a mistake now.
You're still young. You'll find a place for yourself if we get it. But believe me,
I served there for 20 years.
The other guys are probably back home already, I have dropped.
Still alive. The kids, the women. I'll move the rail car so that you can drive through. If you follow them, be careful in the technical tunnel. I heard the bandits talk about the trap there. I'll just rest here for now.
Thank you. The guys are taking too fucking long. I'll have a look out there in the tunnel. See what's up.
Oh, today the shit you make don't even stink so much. A couple of years more and it might even be edible.
Careful!
Careful!
Get
to the
ground!
what? How are we going?
Going well.
What the fuck is up with you? To guard you? The boss said if we let just one snitch they bite, he's gonna have our ass.
No sheesh. Let's go.
Yeah.
thinking going there alone? Okay, okay, you can tell me the tale later. Right now we're entering the fairway and plotting a course to the base.
The snow on the surface starts melting. The familiar rail cars are now joined with boats and fishermen. One of them appeared just in the nick of time. Soon we'll be docked at Venice. Pavel is most probably already there.